institutional investments. So FII and FPI are flows, inflows, which go into essentially stock markets. You know, FII and FPI are, you know, into funding, say, credit card loans. So some money comes in and funds credit card loans, which go at 40%. So Citibank, for example, might invest money in India and lend it out at 40% to as part of credit card or microfinance firms. Just an example. Now, the outflows from India, right? Most of the outflows from India are those companies that are investing in India. They are getting a lot of profits. They take it out and again invest. So it's called reinvested FDA. So somebody sets up a company in India, they make profits, take out the profits, and again recycle it. So this is the capital account. The other one is current account. In the current account, if you see the right side of the...
Gopi, can you please sum up in 10-15 seconds, because a lot of other people has to speak, and we can have another meeting to discuss these things. These are very big topic.
Thank I will you. Summarize in 1 minute, okay? 1 minute. So this is the current account. I'm done, actually. So this is the capital account, the current account. And the current account inflows and outflows, I don't have to explain. You know, these are imports and exports and receipts. And the difference between inflows and outflows, if we have a deficit in the current account, rupee starts weakening, right? RBI's monetary policy is set up such that the value of Indian rupee is decided by the current account transactions. So that means on the current account, if we have more imports than exports and rupee weakens, then that weakened rupee is used for all capital account transactions. So that means somebody brings in $1 billion today into India, they will get 7.6 crores. The real value of rupee only may be 30 rupees, right? And because of that, you know, RBI basically is buying these inflows and builds up forex exchange reserves. So these foreign currency reserves we can see here. And these foreign currency reserves are effectively what India is lending out to rich countries, G7 countries, at 0% interest. So our foreign currency reserves represent money that India has lent today, which is about $500 billion, which is about 35 trillion rupees. It's 35 trillion rupees, you know. 35 trillion rupees, okay? 35 lakh crores, that is a more common thing, right? 35 mahakamma. That is the amount of money India has lent to foreign countries at 0%. And this Gopi, money goes...
Gopi will just take a break.
I'm done.
Then I'm done, you will start your talk.
No, I'm actually done.
You will be speaking after a break.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.